Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, which is a station where you get to watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi, taking you through physics form 3, and we are going to look at refraction, specifically application of refraction. So stay tuned and do pay attention. So what are the goals of this lesson? As I have said, by the end of this lesson, you'll be able to state the application of refraction. So uses of total internal refraction. One example is periscope or prismatic periscope. Here we have glass and perspex which have both a critical angle of about 42. So in each prism, the light strikes the glass air interface at an angle of incidence of 45. While now total internal refraction occurs and the light ray is deviated at an angle of 90 degrees in each prism towards the observer's eye. So you will realize that an obstacle cannot limit the vision of an observer who has a periscope. Why? Because there is total internal refraction which takes place, and this can help an observer to view objects beyond the obstacle. Number two, we have got reflectors. The reflector is made up of many small perspex prism arranged so that the light undergoes total internal reflection twice. So the overall result is that the light is returned into the direction from which it originated. The reflector will be seen to be lit up by from the point of view from the source of, for example, the driver of a car with its headlights on. Example here, as you can see, is a bicycle rear reflector containing many tiny red perspex prisms. Therefore, this helps to safeguard and to be able to identify, and this all happens due to total internal refraction, which is an application of refraction of prisms. Number three, we have what we refer to as optic fibers. An optic fiber or an optical fiber consists of two concentric layers of different types of glasses, core and cladding. That is, they have been placed in a way that total internal refraction will take place. So in case there is light entering the inner core, it will always strike the boundary of the two glasses at an angle that is greater than the critical angle. So what happens is that total internal refraction will take place all through, and there will be no loss of energy whatsoever. So they can be used for transmitting, basically in transmitting electromagnetic radiation, which have got wide application in telecommunication. Optical fiber communication. So optical fibers can be used to transmit information using visible light or infrared radiation. The light cannot escape from the fiber, so it is continually reflected internally by the fiber. So compared with microwaves and radio waves, optical fibers, number one, can carry far more information due to the high frequency of light and infrared, and they are more secure because the signals stay within the fibers. So the fastest broadband uses optical fibers. As you can see from this diagram, this is a perfect example of application of fiber. The other application is the endoscope. The medical endoscope contains two bundles of fibers. One set of fiber transmits light into the body cavity, and the other one is used to return the image to the observer. So this can help us in understanding or investigating internal body structures without the going or without per se having surgery to be taken place. So let's see whether we have understood the goals of this lesson by trying to answer the following question. Number one, state and explain two applications of refraction. So you can refer to secondary physics students book 3 Or you can send us a text message through the numbers on your screen, or visit our Facebook or Erimu TV channel at YouTube, or give us a tweet at @ErimuTV_KE. Once again, I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi. Stay tuned for more lessons to come.